Hey guys, make sure you hit up Star Grinders on Twitter and Instagram to get your badges grinded fast, easy, and legit. And let them know that I sent you. What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy Hollywood Man, and we are back with another video. Now today, it feels good. I'm not gonna lie, it does not actually feel good because I know I'm going back to my toxic days of NBA 2K19 on a shot creating post score. What I got known for, as well as being a lockdown, was a shot creating post score. Now I still have yet to find out a build that technically is my shot post. We did find that 6-7 build, but the 66 post hook proved a little too low for me to actually be able to be a threat on the floor. So I did some digging on YouTube and I found my boy Joe Knows's build. I made some tiny adjustments to it, not very much, but we are going to be rolling with Joe Knows's post score. His link is in the description. Make sure you guys show him some love. Shout out to my boy Joe. But before we get into the video, man, make sure we shout out our brother Connor, who is doing all of our thumbnails. His link is in the description. Go show him some love. Let's go ahead and jump on over to the post score. All right, man. So here we go. We got Don Banyo Center, number 99. We're going to go with righty. Now, there is a couple different variations that you can go for this build. A lot of people are going with the green-blue right here that I'm hovering over. But I do like the thought of having 68 badges on my post score. So I'm actually going to be going with the pure blue. All right, so then we're going to move on to physical profiles. Now, the speed physical profile is not that bad, but that 67 strength on a post score is kind of mediocre. So we're actually going to move on down here. Now, this can be your guys' decision. Personally, I believe that I do need a little bit of vertical with this build to be able to get boards and just get good animations on my dunks and on other situations in game. Now, that extra 6 speed could be a big difference maker. It doesn't really seem like it's going to be much of a difference maker, you know, between a 42 speed and a 48 speed, you'll see here at the end. So I am going to go with the strength and vertical pie chart. Next, we have our finishing category. So for finishing, we're obviously going to max our standing dunk and our post hook, which is going to give us 20 finishing badges right now, but we're going to come back to that top half category here in a minute. So we're going to go up with our free throw and our post fade. That's going to give us 6 shooting. So now that we're done with our shooting category, we're going to move on down to our defensive rebounding category. So in our defensive rebounding category, we are going to go with our interior defense, our offensive rebound, our defensive rebound, and our block. Steal, lateral, and perimeter does not really matter with this build, but that does give us 11 defensive badges, which is pretty phenomenal with this build. We do get a pretty high interior D. So we're going to move on to the next category, which is going to be our playmaking category. In our playmaking category, we're going to max pass accuracy and post moves, and then put up our ball control all the way till we get that 20 playmaking badges. So now we have 20 playmaking badges, 11 defensive rebounding badges, 20 finishing, and 6 shooting, with 30 upgrades left. Now we're going to take the rest of these upgrades. We're going to dump some into our close shot here, which is going to give us a 89 close shot, a 95 standing dunk, a 95 post hook, which allows us to get 30 finishing badges, followed up with a 74 free throw and a 78 post fade. And we have 5 upgrades left, so we're going to dump those into our 3 ball, which will give us 7 shooting badges, a 38 3, a 74 post fade, and a 78 post fade, and a 74 free throw. So to wrap up this build, we get a 37 20 11 with a 55 speed, a 52 acceleration, an 89 strength, and a 70 vertical. Now we're moving on to body type. Now I'm going to explain a little bit about body types this year. Now burly and built are obviously your best two body types for big men. But if you are a guard, you guys are going to want to go with slight compact or maybe even solid or defined, which I would use on lockdowns. But personally, I will be going with either burly or built. I like burly a lot better. I feel like I just look like a big boy on the paint. I'm trying to look like either Fat Julio or Banyo out here. This is more of a Fat Julio type build, so we're going to go with burly. And then we have height. Now, this is where it gets interesting. Now, if I was to want to use this build on the 3s court or the 2s court, I would want to go with a 6'10 or 6'11. That way I can get some sort of speed. This build is going to be very slow at 7-3, but because I plan on using this on the 1v1 court in the toxic stage, we are going to go with 7-3. So now we have our weight. Now there are a couple different options here for weight. We can either go with our minimal weight, which is going to give us a 72 strength with a 52 speed. But we've been basically avoiding speed in every aspect on this build. So why would we go minimal weight? It doesn't really make much sense. Even though you don't really need strength to get a good post hook. Like, you aren't like backing people down with this build. You're going to be mainly doing post spins and changing hands. So you could remake this build, which I will do in the future to give you guys something that you can use as an actual center on the twos and the threes that has the ability to be a post score. But this is a 1v1 court post score, so we are going to go ahead and yank our weight up. Now 290 seems to be a little much here because we can't really get much more strength out of being 290. And that interior defense of an 86 really does not matter. And we take too much of a hit to our vertical, our speed, and our acceleration. So we're actually going to drop this down. As you can see, as we go down, it's going to bring our speed up. And it's going to allow us to get less strength off rip, but we do get more vertical over time. So I do end up coming down with what looks to be a pretty good weight here, where I still get 95 strength. Now, I like the weight 257 because I have 43 speed, 41 acceleration, 95 strength, and 50 vertical. But if you really wanted to, you can go 258, or you could even bring it up a little bit more to the point where you get a 264, I believe. Yeah, 264 gives you a 47 vertical, and it gives you a plus 2 to your interior defense. But personally, I want to go right at that borderline where I can still get 95 strength. So I'm going to go with 257. Now pay attention here. This is where it gets interesting. So when I go 257, I actually don't get 95 strength. So you have to go ahead and back up, and we're going to yank it up to 264, which is going to give us max strength. That way we can get 99 strength on this build with a 41 speed and a 39 acceleration, and you add plus 8 to each of those categories. Then you're going to move into the takeovers, which is going to be post or glass take. Now, obviously, we are a post scorer, so we will be going with post scoring takeover on this build. Now, it's going to come out with shades of Patrick Ewing, Hassan Whiteside, and Yusuf Nurkic. We know those are definitely untrue. This is more of a Shaq, a big Shaq, or a Wilt Chamberlain style build. But let's go ahead and move on over to the build tester. So for the build tester, we're going to yank it all the way up to our 99 overall, obviously. And here is our badges. So for finishing, we do get Hall of Fame finishing. So we're going to start it off with, obviously, Hall of Fame deep hooks, Hall of Fame back down punisher, and Hall of Fame drop stepper. We have to have those big boy badges on. Followed up by a Hall of Fame pro touch, a Hall of Fame contact, a Hall of Fame relentless. And then lastly, we are going to have our Hall of Fame consistent with a silver acrobat. That way, when we do get layup animations on our contact dunks, we are still going to be able to make it and finish around the rim. So that's going to do it for our finishing category. If there's any adjustments you guys would make, feel free to comment down below right now. That way I can make some adjustments myself. Now for shooting, we are obviously going to have to go with deep fades, hot zone hunter, and our Deadeye. Now the only adjustment I would make on this build, I personally would not even run deep fades because I know I am not going to be shooting post fades. I'm going to be post hooking. So I would be running Deadeye with a bronze corner specialist for when I run a post hook. Or you could take off Deadeye and go with gold green machine and a bronze Deadeye. That personally is what I would run right there because I do not plan on shooting post fades on this build. I plan on post hooking everybody out of their existence. Now for playmaking, we are going to run gold quick first step, gold postman technician, gold needle threader, gold bailout, gold unpluckable, gold dream shake, and a silver break starter, or silver pass fake maestro, or a silver pass fake maestro. Now this is a little overkill on badges. I did go with the 68 badge thing just because I wanted to show you guys. Now you guys could sacrifice playmaking in your own build at home. That way you guys can get 14 defensive. But for now, this is going to be the build that I am going to be making. Let's move on over to the defensive rebounding category. Now, as we know, you know, we're 7-3. So we have a great, phenomenal interior defense. So we can run bronze rim, bronze chase down with a bronze or silver intimidator. Then we're going to run gold rebound chaser, silver box, bronze box, actually. And then we're going to throw on a silver pogo stick and a bronze post move lockdown. That way, when people try to do post spins on us or anything like that, we do get good animations to get those stops. So that is going to do it basically for our badges for this build. Man, I hope you guys enjoyed. If there is any post scoring builds out there that you guys have found that you guys want to send to me, feel free to leave them below in the comments. I would love to check them out. I am trying to find my way as a post scorer once again in NBA 2K21. I did not do it in 2K20, and I know you guys missed it. So we're going to drop some post scoring videos going into 2K21 next gen. I don't know if I'll be a post scorer on next gen, but I am planning on doing some post scoring videos for you guys on this 2K21 current gen. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. It's your boy Hollywood. We'll see you in the next one. Peace.